Hello students, in this video I'll be discussing some problems on vector identities. To begin with, let us consider show that gradient of divergence of vector r by r is equal to minus 2 by r cube into vector r. Here r is magnitude of the position vector r. Now to prove this result, we will be making use of the vector identities. Now this problem can be divided into two parts. First, finding the divergence of vector r into r. So we need to make use of, now vector r is, this is a vector, whereas 1 by r is a scalar. So we have divergence of f into vector a, this is equal to f into divergence of vector a plus gradient of f dot a. In terms of symbols, this is so f is 1 by r and vector a is vector r. So divergence of 1 by r into r, this will be 1 by r into divergence of r plus gradient of 1 by r dot vector r. Now divergence of r is dou by dou x of x plus dou by dou y of y plus dou by dou z of z, which is 3. This is because vector r is xi plus yj plus zk. So now r squared is x squared plus y squared plus z squared. That is because r is magnitude of vector r. Now gradient of 1 by r is summation dou by dou x of 1 by r I cap. The remaining terms can be obtained by cyclic change of x, y and z. So this will be summation minus 1 by r squared dou r by dou x I cap. Now since r squared is x squared plus y squared plus z squared, so we have 2r into dou r by dou x equal to 2x, which results in dou r by dou x equal to x by r. This implies gradient of 1 by r is summation minus 1 by r squared into x by r I cap. So gradient 1 by r is minus 1 by r cube summation x I cap, which gives us minus 1 by r cube into vector r. So substituting this and this, we get an expression for divergence. Now, substituting equations 2 and 3 in 1, we obtain divergence 1 by r into vector r to be 1 by r into 3 minus 1 by r cube into vector r dot vector r. So this will be 3 by r minus r squared by r cube. That will give us 2 by r. Now we need to find gradient of divergence of vector r by r. We have found the inner, solve for the inner bracket, that is divergence of 1 by r into vector r. So gradient of divergence of vector r by r, this is equal to gradient 2 by r. We have just found that gradient of 1 by r is minus 1 by r cube into r. So this is, which is minus 1 by r cube into vector r, which is the required result. The next problem that we consider is r power n into vector r. We need to show that r power n into vector r is solenoidal for n equal to minus 3 and irrotational for all values of n. Now to answer this question, now f is solenoidal this implies divergence of vector f equal to 0. Now we have divergence of f into vector a, this to be f divergence of a plus grad f dot vector a. So divergence of r power n into vector r is r power n into divergence of vector r plus gradient r power n dot r. Now divergence of r is dou by dou x of x plus dou by dou y of y plus dou by dou z of z, which is equal to 3. So we'll call this as 1, this as 2. Now gradient r power n is, using the summation, we have dou by dou x of r power n I cap. And this will be summation n r power n minus 1 dou r by dou x I cap. Now r is magnitude of vector r, which implies r squared is x squared plus y squared plus z squared. This gives us 2r dou r by dou x equal to 2x, or dou r by dou x equal to x by r. So gradient r power n is summation n into r power n minus 1 x by r I cap, which simplifies to n into r power n minus 2. Because n r power n minus 2 is a scalar, that will repeat when we expand the summation, so it's taken as a common factor, and we get this to be n r power n minus 2 vector r. Substituting 2 and 3 in 1, this gives us divergence of r power n into vector r equal to r power n into 3 plus n into r power n minus 2 vector r dot vector r. So divergence of r power n into vector r equal to three r power n plus n into r power n minus 2 into r squared, which simplifies to n plus 3 into r power n. We need to show that the given vector is solenoidal, that is, divergence of the vector is 0, and we have divergence of r power n into vector r to be n plus 3 r power n. So this is equation 4. Now divergence of r power n into vector r equal to 0 implies n plus 3 r power n equal to 0. This is for all x, y, z, and r is magnitude of vector r. So r squared will be x squared plus y squared plus z squared. So r power n cannot be 0 at all points. Therefore, we have n plus 3 equal to 0 or n equal to minus 3. Therefore, r power n into vector r is solenoidal if and only if n equal to minus 3. Now to prove the second result, we require to prove that curl of the vector is 0. So vector f is irrotational. This implies curl of f is 0. Now we'll make a note of equation 3 and keep it here. Equation 3 is gradient r power n, which is n into r power n minus 2 vector r. Now curl of f into vector a, this is f curl of vector a plus grad f cross vector a. So curl of r power n into vector r is r power n curl of r plus gradient r power n cross vector r. Now curl of r, this is I j k dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, x, y, z. We can just write the first term, So dou by dou y of z minus dou by dou z of y I cap, which will be 0. So curl of r power n into vector r, this is r power n into 0 plus gradient r power n, we can get it from equation 3, that is n into r power n minus 2 vector r cross r. Now these two are parallel vectors. They differ only in magnitude. So this will be r power n into 0 plus cross product of parallel vectors is also 0. Therefore, this we get it as a 0 vector for all values of n.